हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू दी ऑनलाइन सीईटी नीट एंड जेईई क्लासेस। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व सम मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस ऑन द फर्स्ट ईयर टॉपिक रेडॉक्स रिएक्शंस। सो लेट्स मूव विद द क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, Which of the following represents a redox reaction? What is the question? Which of the following represents a redox reaction? Students, I think already you know what is redox reaction. Redox reaction is the reaction which involves both oxidation and reduction processes. As in the option A, they given NaOH plus HCl gives NaCl plus H2O, and option B, BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives BaSO4 plus 2HCl. Option C, CuSO4 plus 2H2O gives CuOH twice plus H2SO4. Option D, Zn plus 2HCl gives ZnCl2 plus. Students, when we observe the given options, in that option D, see here, if NaOH, when it is react with HCl, what is the required product here? It gives NaCl plus H2O. And if you take second one reaction, that is BaCl2 plus H2SO4, it gives BaSO4 plus 2HCl. Yes, these above reactions are neutralization reactions as they are acid-base reactions. As these are an example for acid base reactions, right? And another one, CuSO4 plus 2H2O gives copper hydroxide and sulfuric acid. Here the oxidation state of copper, it is plus 2, because SO4 is minus 2, then definitely this one is plus 2. Here the oxidation state of copper is plus 2 in both reactant and in product side, means it is same in the reactant as well as product side. Copper oxidation state is plus 2. And SO4 2 minus oxidation does not change, so it is not a redox reaction. But if you take the reaction zinc, when it is reacted with HCl, it forms zinc chloride with hydrogen gas. Yes, it is an example for redox reaction. Why? It is an example for redox reaction because in this particular reaction, zinc changes to Zn2 plus by loss of 2 electrons, and 2H plus by gaining of 2 electrons, it becomes H2. Right? Therefore, both oxidation and reduction processes are involved here. Therefore, the right answer is option D. Option D is the right answer. Next question number 3. Which of the following is the strongest oxidizing agent? Among the following options, which of the following is the strongest oxidizing agent? Option A, I2. Option B, F2. Option C, Cl2. Option D, Br2. Students, among the halogens, fluorine is one of the strongest oxidizing agent. Fluorine molecule is one of the strongest oxidizing agent. It has highest value of oxidation potential. Remember, fluorine, it has highest value of oxidation potential. It is due to its low heat of dissociation and high heat of hydration, which have more than compensated the lower value of electron affinity. Yes, the reduction potential is in the order of F2 greater than Cl2 greater than Br2 greater than I2. Yes, this is the reduction potential order. Reduction potential order. This is the reduction potential order. Yes, which one is the right answer for third question? Option B is the right answer. Yes, next question number 5. Which of the following leads to redox reaction? Among the given options, which of the following leads to redox reaction? Option A, silver nitrate plus hydrochloric acid reaction. Option B, potassium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid reaction. And option C, potassium iodide plus Cl2. Option D, ammonia plus HCl. Which one is the right answer? Students, when we observe the given options reactions, among the given options, option C, here I take option C reaction. When potassium iodide is react with the chlorine molecule, then we get KCl2 plus half I2. Yes. Now, in Ki, here, in Ki, the oxidation state of iodine. Iodine is minus 1 because halogens have oxidation state of minus 1. This changes to 0. At minus 1, it changes to 0. Yes, in the reactant side, this is minus 1. But in product side, this is 0. Means minus 1 value get changes to 0. Yes, then Cl. Cl has 0 oxidation state in the reactant side and it changes to minus 1 by 2. It changes to minus 1 by 2 in KCl2. Here this is 1 by 2, right? Minus 1 by 2. So, as iodine is increases its oxidation state from minus 1 to 0 or 1 to 0, Cl decreasing its oxidation 0 to 1 by 2. So, this must be a redox reaction. So, this one is the redox reaction. So, option C is the right answer. Yes, next question number 7, students. Which of the following is a redox reaction? Which of the following is a redox reaction? Options are given here with respect to reactions. So carefully observe all the reactions and select which one is an example for redox reaction. Students, when we observe the given options in this. The option D, see here, this one reaction, Zn plus 2 AgCN, silver cyanide, S. Here, Zn, it changes to Zn 2 plus by loss of 2 electrons, right? Here, oxidation state of Zn, it changes 0 to plus 2. And the other side, Ag plus, by getting electron, it changes to Ag in the product side. As in A, B and C option, oxidation number does not change. In other reaction, oxidation number does not change, but in the option D, oxidation number changes. In one side it increases and one side it decreases. Therefore, it is an example for redox reaction. So option D is the right answer. You can separately observe and write down once again the reactions and observe the change in the oxidation number of particular element. Students, in the option A, B, C, There is no change in the oxidation number. Next question number 10. Which of the following statements is not correct about the reaction given below? Which of the following statements is not correct? Yes, see this point. Among the given options, which one is not correct about the reaction given below? Yes, here, one complex is given during the oxidation process, it changes to Fe3 plus plus CO2 plus NO3 minus. Yes, the given options are, option A, Fe is oxidized from Fe plus 2 to Fe plus 3. Option B, carbon is oxidized from C2 plus to C plus 4. Option C, nitrogen is oxidized from N3 minus to N5 plus. And option D, carbon is not oxidized. Yes, which one is the right answer? Students, oxidation state of carbon in complex. See this one. Oxidation state of carbon in complex K4 FeCN6 is same as that of the FeCN6 4 minus. Yes, oxidation state of carbon in complex K4 FeCN6 is same as that of the FeCN6 4 minus. Now the carbon, it is in the form of, the carbon is in the form of CN minus. There the oxidation state of carbon be X. Oxidation state of carbon, here it is taken as X. Yes, now X plus minus 3 equal to minus 1, and X equal to 3 minus 2 is equal to plus 2. Now in CO2, X plus 2 into minus 2 equal to 0, X equal to plus 4. So the change in oxidation state of carbon by 2. So carbon is oxidized from C plus 2 to C plus 4. Right. Hence option D is right. Because they given option D, carbon is not oxidized. But here carbon oxidation state is changes from plus 2 to plus 4, means it gets oxidized. Yes, option D is our answer. Next question number 12. The oxidant which cannot act as a reducing agent is, as among the given options, the oxidant which cannot act as a reducing agent. Option A, sulfur dioxide, SO2. Option B, nitrogen dioxide, NO2. Option C, carbon dioxide, CO2. And option D, chlorate, ClO2. Students, when we observe the given options, we think about one theoretical concept. A substance which can act as a reducing agent when it can increases its oxidation state by losing the electrons. Students, in SO2, sulfur is present in plus 4 oxidation state. As in presence of SO2, sulfur oxidation state is plus 4 because oxygen valency means charge. It is minus 2, 2 into minus 2, that is minus 4, then only it is equal to 0. Therefore, oxidation state of sulfur in SO2, that is plus 4. Next, in SO2, sulfur is present in plus 4 oxidation state, but it can increase its oxidation state up to plus 6. So it can act as a reducing agent because in SF6 it is plus 6. And take another option, NO2. Nitrogen is present in plus 4 oxidation state. It can increase its oxidation state up to plus 5. So it can act as a reducing agent. As if you take an example, nitrogen dioxide, here nitrogen oxidation state is plus 4 and it also increase its oxidation state up to plus 5, so it can also act as a reducing agent. And in CO2, carbon is present in plus 4 oxidation state, here carbon oxidation state is plus 4, which is maximum oxidation state, as plus 4 is the maximum oxidation state of carbon, so it cannot act as a reducing agent because it does not show another or increased oxidation state. As but if you take another option, ClO2, chlorine is present in plus 4 oxidation state, it can increase its oxidation state up to plus 7, you know. So it can act as a reducing agent. Yes. Therefore, the oxidant which cannot act as a reducing agent is CO2. Means option C is the right answer. Next question number 15. In the reaction, as here one reaction is given, Cr2O7 2- react with H plus plus 6I-, then we get the product 2 moles of Cr3 plus plus 7H2O plus 3I2. Which element is reduced here? Option A, iodine. Option B, oxygen. Option C, hydrogen. Option D, chromium. Yes, which one is the right answer? Students, in Cr2O7 2 or 2-, yes, in Cr2O7 2-, here oxidation state of chromium, it is plus 6. In the product, oxidation state of chromium is plus 3. In the product side, Cr oxidation they given in the reaction, that is plus 3. There is a reduction in the oxidation number of chromium from reactant to product. Yes. If you observe another reaction, 2I minus, that changes to I2, means I, 6I minus, that is changes to 3I2, it shows oxidation because loss of electron. Cr plus 6 oxidation changes to plus 3 by gain of electrons. Right? Therefore, option D, these elements get reduced. Therefore, option D is the right answer. Next, question number 17. Which quantities are conserved in all oxidation reduction reactions? Which quantities are conserved in all oxidation reduction reactions? Option A, charge only. Option B, mass only. Option C, both charge and mass. Option D, neither charge nor mass. Which one is the right answer? Students, it is one of the theoretical question. You must remember the concept, both charge and mass conserved in an oxidation reduction reactions. Both charge and mass, they conserve in the oxidation reduction reaction. Therefore, the direct answer for the given question is option C. Next, question number 21. The conversion of sugar C12H22O11 sucrose to CO2. Conversion of sugar from sucrose to carbon dioxide. Yes. Option A, it is the oxidation reaction or oxidation process. Option B, reduction. Option C, both oxidation and reduction. Option D, neither oxidation nor reduction. Students, here conversion of one of the sugar to carbon dioxide takes place. It is an example for oxidation reaction. Why it is an oxidation reaction? See here, sucrose are also called as table sugar. Right, its formula is C12H22O11. What is this? Sucrose, or also called as table sugar, is oxidized in the body by O2. Yes, it is oxidized in the body by oxygen by a complex set of the reactions that ultimately products, and it produces CO2 and H2O. It produces CO2 and H2O. Right? Therefore, it is an oxidation process. Option A is the right answer. Next, question number 23. The reaction in which hydrogen peroxide act as a oxidizing agent is. The reaction in which hydrogen peroxide act as a oxidizing agent is. Option A, PbS plus 4H2O2 gives PbSO4 plus 4H2O. Here lead sulfide get changes to lead sulfate. Option B, 2Ki plus H2O2 gives 2KOH plus I2. Option C, 2FeSO4 plus H2SO4 plus H2O2 gives Fe2SO4 thrice plus 2H2O. Option D, Ag2O plus H2O2 gives 2Ag plus H2O plus O2. Which one is the right answer? Carefully observe the question and given option, students. Yes, when we observe the given reactions respectively, in the reaction I write here, that is PbS plus 4H2O2, it gives PbS 3SO4 plus 4H2O. S. Once again, you observe the given reaction. In this reaction, hydrogen peroxide, see this one, H2O2. In this reaction, hydrogen peroxide act as an oxidizing agent. It acts as an oxidizing agent. It oxidizes. This H2O2 means hydrogen peroxide. It oxidizes PbS2, PbSO4. Then H2O2 itself, it reduces to H2O. H2O2 itself, it reduces to H2O. One note point you remember here, addition of oxygen is oxidation and removal of oxygen is reduction. Yes. Therefore, option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. But in Ag2O, if you observe the last reaction, yes, which one is the right answer? Yes, in Ag2O, oxidation number of Ag is plus 1. In Ag, the oxidation state is 0. There is a gain of electrons. Hence, H2O2. Here also there is a oxidation and reduction process takes place. Therefore, option D is also right here. We select anyone among A and D. Okay, next question number 25. Which substance serves as a reducing agent in the following reaction? Which substance serves as a reducing agent in the following reaction? What is the reaction? Observe carefully. 14H plus plus Ar2O7 2 minus plus 3Ni gives 2Cr3 plus plus 7H2O plus 3Ni 2 plus. Option A, H2O. Option B, Ni. Option C, H plus. Option D, Cr2O7 2 minus. Students, once again I write the given reaction here, that is 14H plus plus of Cr2O7 2 minus plus of 3Ni gives 2Cr3 plus of 7H2O plus of 3Ni 2 plus. Yes, here the compound that undergoes oxidation itself and reduces others is known as reducing agent. We know this point. In this reaction, oxidation number of nickel changes from 0 to plus 2. Here nickel in the reactant side, this is 0 plus, but in the product side it is changes to 2 plus. Means nickel oxidation number changes from 0 to plus 2. Hence nickel act as a reducing agent. Right? In the reactant side, the oxidation state of nickel is 0. But in the product side, it changes to plus oxidation state of plus 2. Hence, it undergoes oxidation, but itself it reduces. As therefore, nickel is the right answer. It is one of the substance which serves as a reducing agent. Next question number 29. When NaCl is dissolved in water, When NaCl is dissolved in water, the sodium ion becomes. When NaCl is dissolved in water, the sodium ion becomes. Option A, oxidized. Option B, reduced. Option C, hydrolyzed. Option D, hydrated. Students, here first I write the reaction. What happens when sodium chloride is dissolved in water? Yes, I take NaCl. It is treated with water, then the products like NaOH plus HCl is formed. Yes, sodium ion. What happens here? Students, when sodium chloride dissolved in water, sodium and chloride ions and the polar water molecules are strongly attracted to one another by ion-dipole interactions. Remember this point. When sodium chloride dissolved in water, the sodium and chloride ions and the polar water molecules are strongly attracted to one another by ion-dipole interactions. The solvent molecules surround the ions, removing them from the crystal and forming the solution. As the dissolving process proceeds, the individual ions are removed from the solid surface, becoming completely separate. Therefore, hydrated species observed in the solution. Therefore, the right answer for the given question is option D, hydrated. Option D, hydrated. Next, question number 33. In a reaction of KMnO4 and more salt, FeSO4 is oxidized to. In a reaction of KMnO4 and more salt, FeSO4 is oxidized to. Option A, Fe2+. Option B, Fe3+. Option C, Fe. Option D, all of these. Yes, which one is the right answer, students? Students, first I write the required equation according to the question, that is 2MnO4 minus plus 10Fe2+ plus of 16H+. During this particular reaction, we get the products like 10Fe3+ plus of 2Mn2+ and 8H2O. Yes, this is the reaction according to the question. KMnO4 versus more salt. Yes, what happens? FeSO4 is oxidized to. Option A, Fe2+. Option B, Fe3+. Option C, Fe. And option D, all of the above. Yes, students, when you observe the given reaction, here Fe plus 2 is changes to Fe plus 3. Here this Fe plus get changes to Fe 3 plus. Therefore, FeSO4 is oxidized to Fe 3 plus. Therefore, option B is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Next, question number 35. Which of the following is the strongest reducing agent in aqueous medium? Which of the following is the strongest reducing agent in aqueous medium? Option A, Mg. Option B, Na, sodium. Option C, lithium. Option D, calcium. Students, among the given options, here Li means lithium. It changes to Li plus by loss of one electron in an aqueous medium. Remember, lithium is the strongest reducing agent. Lithium is the strongest reducing agent because the high negative enthalpy of hydration that compensate for the high ionization energy. Remember this one. In an aqueous medium, lithium is one of the strongest reducing agent since the high negative enthalpy of hydration compensate high ionization energy. Therefore, option C is the right answer. Which one is the right answer? Lithium is one of the strongest reducing agent in aqueous medium. Next question number 37. The oxidation number of cobalt in K3CO CO4 is, means here one complex is given here. Option A plus 1, option B plus 3, option C minus 1, option D minus 3. As which one is the right answer? Question is the oxidation number of cobalt in K3CO means cobalt carbonyl group with 4 is given here. As students, how you calculate the oxidation number? I write once again the complex here, K3CO CO4. As this one is the given complex. Already you know alkali metals means group 1 elements containing plus 1 oxidation state, therefore plus 1 into 3, that is plus 3. And here carbonyl group contain 0 oxidation state. Therefore oxidation state of cobalt, oxidation state of cobalt, it is equal to minus 3, because overall complex charges becomes sum of the terms is becomes equal to 0 in the molecular form, right? As therefore cobalt, its oxidation number is minus 3. Therefore the right answer is option D. Option D is the right answer. Next question number 39. The oxidation number of sulfur in Na2S4O6 is. Na2S4O6 is. Yes. How you calculate the oxidation number? Option A plus 0.5, option B 2.5, option C plus 4, and option D plus 6. Students, I think you know oxidation number of sulfur. Here it is taken as X. Oxidation number of sodium is plus 1. Yes, I write once again this term Na2S4O6. Here this one must be, we want to calculate. That is taken as X, and you know sodium oxidation state is plus 1 and oxidation state of oxygen is minus 2. Sum of all oxidation number is, here I write 2 into 1 means plus 1, plus of 4 into X plus 6 into minus 2. Yes, 4x minus 10 is equal to 0. As this must be equal to 0. Here x equal to 10 by 4, which equals to 2.5. Yes. The compound must have sulfur atoms with mixed oxidation states. Since it is normal for sulfur to have oxidation state of minus 2, 0, plus 2, plus 4, and plus 6. It is most likely that there are 3 sulfur with plus 2 oxidation state and 1 sulfur that is plus 4. Hence, option B, 2.5 is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. Next question number 41. In which of the following processes nitrogen is oxidized? Among the given options, where the nitrogen is oxidized? Option A, NH4 plus changes to N2. Option B, NO3 minus get changes to NO. Option C, NO2 changes to NO2 minus. And option D, NO3 minus changes to NO4 plus. Which one is the right answer? Students, when we observe the given options, in NH4 plus it changes to N2, here the oxidation state of nitrogen changes from minus 3 to 0. Therefore, it is oxidized. Therefore, it is oxidized. And in NO3 minus 2 NO, means when we observe the option B, the oxidation state of nitrogen changes from plus 5 to plus 2. Where? In NO3 minus changes to NO. Here, the oxidation state of nitrogen changes from plus 5 to plus 2. Thus, it is reduced. Yes, this is reduced. In another reaction, NO2 minus, the oxidation state of nitrogen changes from plus 4 to plus 3. Yes, therefore it is also reduced. And in another reaction, that is NO3 minus 2 NH4 plus. Here the oxidation state of nitrogen changes from plus 5 to minus 3. Therefore, it is also reduced. Yes. Therefore, which one is oxidized here? Option A, NH4 changes to N2. Here oxidation number of nitrogen changes from minus 3 to 0. Therefore, it is oxidized. Option A is the right answer. Next question number 43. The oxidation number of Cl in CaOCl is? The oxidation number of Cl in CaOCl2 is? How you calculate this? Students, here the given term is CaOCl2. I write once again here in CaOCl and another Cl. Two Cl atoms are in different oxidation state. Remember, in the given term, two Cl atoms are in the different oxidation state. Is that one Cl minus? Cl minus, it contains minus one oxidation state, and other as OCl minus. OCl minus, here it is in plus one oxidation state. If you observe the structure, they given as that is OCl and another one Cl. Here its oxidation number is minus 1, here that is plus 1. Right? Yes. Therefore, option A, minus 1 and plus 1 is the right answer. Students, remember Ca means calcium, its oxidation number is 2 plus. In OCl, Cl oxidation number is plus 1. And in Cl, you know, Cl means halogens usually having minus 1 oxidation state. एस, देयर फोर माइनस वन एंड प्लस वन ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज ऑब्जर्व्ड हियर, देयर फोर ऑप्शन ए इज द राइट आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 45. In which of the following compounds the oxidation state of transition metal is zero? In which of the following compounds the oxidation state of transition metal is zero? Option A CrO5, option B Fe3O4, option C FeSO4, and option D FeCO5. Yes, which one is the right answer? Students, in option B and C, there is no transition metal, so these can be eliminated, right? In option B and C. Next, in FeCO5, carbon monoxide is one of the neutral ligand, therefore no involvement of Fe electrons in the complex. Here Fe has zero oxidation state, therefore option D is the correct answer. The oxidation state of transition metal, it becomes zero in the option D. As which one is the right answer? Option D is the right answer. Next, question number 47. The oxidation number of platinum Pt in PtC2H4Cl3- is option A plus 1, option B plus 2, option C plus 3, option D plus 4. Let's calculate. Students, here the given term is taken as X. Let X be the oxidation state, oxidation state of platinum in Pt C2H4Cl3-. Since the overall charge on the complex is -1, overall charge is -1. The sum of oxidation state of all the elements, it should be equal to -1. Therefore, X plus 0 minus 3 equal to -1. Therefore, X equal to +2. That is your answer. Option B is the right answer. +2. The oxidation number of platinum in given complex, that is +2. Next, question number 50. In which of the following complexes oxidation state of metal is zero? In which of the following complexes oxidation state of metal is zero? Let's carefully observe the given options and select which one is the right answer. Oxidation state of metal where it is zero. Yes, which one is the right answer, students? Definitely option B is the right answer, because when we observe the given options with the complexes, there is a carbonyl group, therefore here oxidation state of metal it becomes zero, because in CrCO6 oxidation state of metal in metal carbonyl is zero. Remember this term. Oxidation state of metal in metal carbonyl is zero because in CrCO6 oxidation state of ligand molecule is zero and complex as a whole neutral. So the change on the central metal atom will also be zero. Remember, CrCO6 is metal carbonyl, hence oxidation state of chromium is zero. Next, question number 52. Which of the following elements has least oxidation number? Which of the following elements has least oxidation number? Option A, NiCN4. Option B, NiCO4. Option C, Fe2O3. And option D, SF6. Yes, one by one. See here, NiCN4. I take first one, NiCN4. Here, nickel. You know, Cn, it is minus 1, therefore 4 into minus 1, that is minus 4, definitely nickel oxidation is plus 4 here. And I take another one, Ni, carbonyl group is present, yes, definitely metal carbonyl, therefore its oxidation number is nothing but 0. Yes, another one, Fe2O3. Fe2O3, here oxygen 3 into minus 2 means minus 6. Fe2 value becomes plus 6, but only I take Fe, that is plus 3. As next, I take SF6. Here halogens, especially fluorine, it has minus 1 oxidation state, 6 into minus 1, that is minus 6, and sulfur value is plus 6. Yes, which one has lowest value? Which one has least oxidation number, students? Question number 52. Which one is the right answer? Metal carbonyls. Here metal always has zero oxidation number. Therefore, option P is the right answer. Next, question number 58. The oxidation number of sulfur in S8, S2, F2, H2S respectively are. Yes, calculate one by one. Students, oxidation number of sulfur in S8 in the molecular form, oxidation number is 0. Yes, oxidation number of sulfur in S8 is 0. As in S8, sulfur exists in elemental form, so it has 0 oxidation state. Then oxidation number of sulfur in S2, F2. Oxidation number of sulfur in S2, F2. Here fluorine, F, its oxidation number is minus 1, therefore 2 into minus 1, that is minus 2. When the sum of oxidation terms becomes equal to 0, now S2 value is plus 2, but only sulfur value is plus 1. As oxidation number of fluorine is minus 1. And oxidation number of sulfur in H2S, that is minus 2. Here sulfur oxidation state is minus 2, as oxidation number of hydrogen is plus 1. As which one is the right answer now? 0 plus 1 minus 2. 0 plus 1 minus 2 is the right answer. Therefore, option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. One thing you remember, oxidation state of element in its pre-state is 0. And another one, sum of oxidation state of all atoms in compounds is 0. In S8, sulfur oxidation state is 0. And in S2, F2, it is plus 1. And in H2S, that is minus 2. Option A is the right answer. Okay, thank you, students. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we will solve some more multiple choice questions on the same topic, redox reaction. Thank you.